Hey everybody, welcome to the channel, welcome to Face the Music, glad that you're here with me today. Hey look, today's going to be an exciting day, today's going to be a little bit of a different day actually for me, and the reason for that is because I'm going to be featuring music from an artist that I know pretty well, but I don't know this song. So that may sound a little bit strange, but it's absolutely true. Now, first of all, this channel, the design of this channel is not just for me to like listen to new music that I've never heard before that you guys can introduce to me. You know, artists like Tommy Johansson, Nightwish, Sabaton, Dan Vass. You know, artists that I didn't know anything about until I started this channel, and it's been a great ride with those artists. But part of the design is also to put out music that you guys maybe don't know that I can share with you. And so it's kind of like a two-way street, so to speak. Now, for me, in this case, it's a little bit different because, again, this is an artist that I know very well and know most all of their music. I thought I did, at least their big, big hits. And, you know, Freddie Mercury, Brian May, Roger Taylor, John Deacon, those guys, I've, you know, been listening to them ever since I was a kid. But I don't know this song. And in fact, I don't even know what album it comes from. When I think about all the Queen albums, in fact, I'm going to do something here that I normally don't do right in the middle of a show. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to check out where this song, what album this comes from. You know, this is supposed to be a 1981 performance, so possibly it comes from like Queen 1, Queen 2. I don't know when those albums came out. A Night at the, you know, A Night at the Opera, A Day at the Races. I don't know. So let's see. Dragon. I'm going to just look this up right as I'm doing this. Dragon Attack Queen. It comes from, excuse me. Okay. The Game, 1980. Okay, I had the wrong album on in any event. Wow, that's crazy. Okay, was not anywhere close to it. Okay, so anyways, but so Dragon Attack. So I remember doing some other, if you look down in my playlist section, I've got a lot of Queen episodes that I've done, or at least a few. I'm not sure how many exactly, but I've done a few. You know, mostly taken from their 1986 Wembley concert. This one is taken from a 1981 concert, I believe, in Montreal, like I said before. And like I said, I don't know the song. And I had some people before on some of my other videos say, hey, you ought to do like this song, that song, the other song. And check out the Dragon Attack from the 1981 show. And I'm like, Dragon Attack, never even heard the song. So anyways, this is going to be a new one for me. If you know this song, if you're familiar with this clip, then you already know. I'm looking forward to a great one because, like I say, I've never heard the song, never seen this footage. And so it's an artist that I'm familiar with, but I absolutely am in a void when it comes to this right here. So no more talking. Here we go. This is going to be Queen 1981 in Montreal. And Dragon Attack.
Yeah. I said, yeah.
Best front man ever.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. Come on, do it to the beat. Yeah. All right. Okay.
Thank you. Wow, what a fantastic song. Dragon Attack by Queen, 1981, Montreal. Wow, that was absolutely cool. You know, and I've seen, I had to actually look up, you know, what the song was about before, you know, playing it, because I don't know, you know, this song, Dragon Attack. I mean, is it about dragons? Is it, you know, was it, what kind of attack are we talking about? And I've seen a number of different interpretations about what the song is actually about. So, you know, regardless of which one is accurate, which one is not, I mean, just watching that, like I said, I had never heard that song before until just then when I played it right there. And, you know, it's cool to see, for me, it's always cool to see, especially a song that I don't know from an artist that I do know, and to see, you know, back in the day, in their heyday, 19, I guess, that, like I said before at the outset, this song came out from their The Game album, 1980. You know, so this was their, you know, kind of in their heyday. This was, you know, the late 70s, early 80s. You know, I mean, they were just rocking it and killing it all over the place. And it was cool to see, first of all, best frontman ever. I've said this before on multiple videos of mine, best frontman ever, Freddie Mercury. I don't know if anyone's ever going to be able to tell me that I'm wrong on that and show me for definite proof that I'm incorrect. You know, I separate frontman. You know, for example, Elvis, great front man. And when I say front man, I mean, he really was just his own solo artist. He had a backing band, but just Elvis by himself as his own artist, great, fantastic. You know, his voice, his, you know, his style can't be touched. But when it comes to music groups, when you talk about front man, that front and actual band, Freddie Mercury, I mean, you can't get any better than that. You know, and if you're a Freddie fan, I'm sure you agree with me on that. Now, and to see him here on stage with, you know, again, a video I've never seen before, to see a concert that I've never seen before. I've pretty much seen like the Wembley show a lot, but then, you know, to see him interact so well with Brian and with Roger behind the drums, I mean, it was just great. You know, John Deacon on bass, and, you know, especially when Roger, for example, going back to Roger on the drums, and he was playing the drums, and Freddie was walking around to Roger's left side, and Roger just followed him the whole way over, watching what was going on, because of course the drummers, you know, leading the show. Basically, Freddie's the front man, but, you know, he's providing the beat. He's providing, he's got to know whether or not there's going to be something going on, you know, that he needs to change up. Just fantastic. You know, the only complaint I have about this song, the only thing that I can say negative about this song, is it is too short. Too short. Too short. I mean, I'm just like, I'm watching this thing, and I'm waiting for this thing to go on and on and on and on. I want to see what's going to happen. I want to see what's going to go on next. And then it ends, and I'm like, ah, you know. But anyways, great song, great performance. Whoever, and I think there was multiple people, but for those of you, whoever you know you are and you know who you are, whoever recommended that song, thank you. That was absolutely fantastic. Now I've got to go back. I've never done this before, right? I've never gone and sat down and listened to Queen albums front to back all the way through. I don't have all the Queen albums. I really probably should go out there and get some more than I already have. But, you know, I've never really sat down and listened to them all the way through, and I'm sure there's a lot of gems that I'm missing, so I have got to, like, correct that, and I've got to go out there and just, you know, just listen to them all the way through and just see what else is out there other than what I already know, other than the big songs, excuse me, from Queen and from the band back in their heyday especially. But, I mean, that was fantastic. I'm blown away. That is just, I want to see more of that. I might have to actually, you know, now I'm going to have to go out and look at other concerts and look at other performances and see, and hopefully maybe I can find a longer version or whatever. I don't know. I'm not listening to the album version. I don't even know what the album version sounds like. Excuse me. If the album version, if the concert version is this good, I can't even imagine what the album version is. Wow. That was fantastic. Anyways, well, I really, really enjoyed that. Guys, keep up the recommendations on Queen, and there's probably a lot of other music that maybe I'm missing that you may know about that I just maybe somehow just, you know, when this song came out, I was only 10, so maybe there's things I'm missing that you guys might know about. Let me know, put it in the comment box below, and I'm going to definitely want to go ahead and go, as we go forward, checking them out. But anyways, that was fantastic. Really, really enjoyed that. I hope that you did as well. Well, that's it for today's episode. If you're not a subscriber to my channel, do me a favor. If you would, reach over, hit that subscribe button, join our family. Let's keep all this great music alive together, just like that song right there. Also, check down below. I have a hashtag, FaceTheMusicReactions. You click on that, it'll take you to another page. All my previous stuff's there. I'm sure you'll find other great music that you'll enjoy as well. Set up your notifications also so that whenever I drop a new episode, maybe even another Queen episode, you'll be among the first to find out. And come on back, because I have a lot more great content lined up for you. I'll see you next time right here on Face the Music. Take care.